Adenopathy. Ali Saleh, one of the famous interventional pulmonologists in Papillon. You have 10 minutes, Ustad Ali. Inshallah.
اوكي اوكي السلام عليكم جميعا. لي الشرف طبعا ان اكون يعني موجود هنا بهذا المؤتمر اللي هو مؤتمرنا السنوي، واكيد المؤتمر منور بالاساتذه والزملاء الموجودين، وفرصه لطيفه ان نتبادل بها المعلومات العلميه، وكذلك فرصه لطيفه للامور السوشيال ان نتشاوف ويا اساتذتنا الاعزاء وزملائنا الافاضل. فأكرر شكري للجمعية من جديد، و hope I will do my best to give the message in a clear and sharp points, and I try to stick to the time. أو بدل time لو ما حد يجي دان تظهر attendance. Okay, I will speak about the medicinal lymphadenopathy and the role of EBOS in. We used أنه نبدي دائما تعريفنا عن الإي باص أنه هو new facilities اللي تسوي كذا وكذا، لكن unfortunately أعتقد we had passed this point. أعتقد الكل صار familiar with الإي باص. It is in some sort of endobronchial ultrasound with two types, radial and linear. The radial one هذا شنو؟ هذا عبارة عن thin أو slim ultrasound probe يسوي ultrasound to the forward. فبالتالي it can't see the lesion in front. This is one of the navigation, and really it is the only real-time navigation tool we got in IP. What I want to talk about, it's the use of convex EBOS. It is هذا الفائدة من عنده beside the branch ultrasound, so it can't see the mediastinum. And that's why it is a big chance to explore the mediastinum. The indication. The indication of doing convex EBOS, I mean a mediastinal EBOS, it is three main indications. One is for staging, and this is our main topic to our lecture. The second, it is for diagnosis of undiagnosed lymphadenopathy or a mass paratracheal area. By the way, this is not a so popular indication in all over the world, but this is main indication in our practice. Really, I practice EBOS since more than 7 years in Iraq. I can say more than 90% of the indication of EBOS I do it is for evaluation of undiagnosed mass of lymphadenopathy. And the last one is the therapeutic for a drainage of branchial cyst. Really, I do it just one time. But mostly, most of cases, I do it for the second indication, اللي هي for diagnosis of unsettled mass. Really, الفرق بين الindication الأول والindication الثاني فرق كبير جدا. It is a two-way divert. ليش؟ الطريق الأول اللي هو طريق الستيجينج. شنو يعني الستيجينج؟ أني عندي lesion. أني عندي mass باللونج, which is diagnosed already as a case of lung cancer. And I have to do staging هنا حتى أقدر أشوف the mediastinum is involved or not in order to say it is a candidate for surgery or not. فهنا I had two answer. يعني من أسوي the procedure I got two answer. لو أكو لو ماكو. أكو انتهت. This is mediastinal involvement. He is beyond surgery. ماكو I will go for mediastinoscope for evaluation. So I got two answer just. المشكلة الثانية وين؟ المشكلة بالإنديكيشن الثاني for undiagnosis يدخل عندنا البناين ليجين، واللي أعتقد الكل إحنا متفقين ويمكن لو موجودين الباثولوجيست يشاطرونه، البناين ليجين بالبلمونولوجي مشكلة، مشكلة. يعني أنا راح بالدايكنوسيس أنا تطلع عندي ثلاث نتائج، تطلع عندي أكو مالجننت وتطلع عندي ماكو مالجننت. هاي الماكو مالجننت ممكن تكون فولس نيجاتيف وممكن تكون بناين ليجين. وهذه مشكلة كبيرة. يعني you may end, يعني المريض يجيك because of undiagnosed lymphadenopathy, and you after the procedure you will end by undiagnosed lymphadenopathy. فلذلك I will talk today about the staging. And this is the staging. EBUS معناها patient is already a known case of malignancy, and I want to evaluate the mediastinum to see whether he's a good candidate for surgery or not. This is the British Society indication to do the EBUS staging. You can say that the level of recommendation is C. لكن هذه بال 2010. بال 2010. Now it is a well known and a sharp and a definite. It is an indication for do mediastinal EBUS for, let's say, staging almost always. وراح نشوف الانديكيشن مالتها شنو. Mediastinal staging شنو يعني؟ Patient, he's a known case of malignancy. والimaging انطاني three results. Either a normal size mediastinum, mean lymph node أقل من 1 cm, or a discrete lymph nodes, multiple lymph nodes with 1 cm and more, or infiltrated mediastinum. So I have to do staging here to know or to say which is operable, which is non-operable. بالنسبة للrelation بين CT scan أو PET scan with the EBUS, it is not always. بالnegative, يعني بالCT scan, if negative CT scan, بالperipheral tumor and central tumor I can divide it. If it's positive imaging, discrete أو mediastinal involvements. خلي نبديهم واحدة واحدة. This is a case of malignancy already diagnosed as a malignant, a non-small cell lung cancer. And his PET scan shows this picture. It is a case of positive CT mediastinum, infiltrative mediastinum, imaging-wise. Here, there is no rule for EBUS. Here, he's for palliative treatment. He's beyond surgery. انتهى الموضوع قضي الأمر. The second indication, I got a patient with a known case of malignancy and he got a positive PET scan or CT. قال لك أبو CT عدة discrete lymph node more than 1 cm in the mediastinum. هذه الفالس بوزيتيف 40% والفالس بوزيتيف بالبيت حوالي 20%، فالس نيجاتيف حوالي 25%. اللي أريد أقوله مو كل lymph node positive بالCT it is involved lymph node. مو كل lymph node positive بالPET he is beyond surgery. فهنا in this indication when a patient have a positive discrete lymph node, high lymph node, it should be sampled. Should be sampled. In a patient with discrete positive PET scan and central tumor should EBUS. We should do EBUS. Third case, a negative PET scan. Patient, known case of non-small cell lung cancer. And negative PET scan, the PET قال لك عدة lymph node less than 1 cm أو ماكو lymph node بالmediastinum. But it is a central tumor. A central tumor, you should do EBUS evaluation. We should do even if the PET scan is negative. Because there is a high false negative, حوالي 25%. يعني إحنا ممكن تحرم مريضك من surgery, prolonged survival because of non-evaluated properly mediastinum. أو بالعكس, you can do a surgery for a patient ويرجع لك ورا 6 شهور بريكرنس because it is simply an N2 disease. فالindication الثاني للevaluation of EBUS is a negative PET scan with a central tumor. Third case, if I got an, or fourth case, sorry, negative PET scan but a peripheral tumor, just like this. المediastinum ما بيها شيء. وعندي peripheral tumor. Here, no need for EBUS. Surgery رأسا. Surgery رأسا. Okay? So, in conclusion, هذا السلايد اللي يلخص لنا كل الحكي. In conclusion, أني عدي CT scan positive desecrate ايبر انفلتريت هاي راديو بيون سيرجري انتهى سيت سكان نيجاتيف بيريفرال تيومر سيرجري نو نيد تو دو ايبس سنترال تيومر ايبس سو عندي تو انديكيشن اسوي بها ايبس بيريفرال تيومر وذ نورمال بيتس و بوزيتيف بيتس انفلتريت بيدستاينال والديسكريت والنيجاتيف اي هاف تو جو فور ايبس لكن الكلمة المهمة if the EBUS is positive he's beyond surgery if the EBUS is negative I should go for mediastinoscopy هاي المسج المهمة اللي أرد أوصلها لأنه أعتقد كلش لقطة قاسية أن مريض أنت مشتغلة وعملية وميجر سيرجري ورا ست أشهر يرجع لك metastasis ف we should do هاي الإيفاليويشن prior to any surgery بالإيبوس عندنا تو جوب عندنا سكان وسامبلينج This scan, I should pass on this lymph nodes. هاي الستيجنج كنت عرفوها. And this is...
Just 2 minutes, استاذ علي.
عندي ما بقى لي شيء. And this is the lymph node that I have to come cross it. يمكن الناس اللي يشتغلون إيبوس, أنا دائما أحكي على الحكاية, هاي لازم يحفظوها أكثر ما حافظين أسماء مواليد جهالهم. لكنه بالنسبة للناس اللي فقط, they should know معلومة واحدة. هذا السهم. هذا السهم من الكراينة وفوق أي شيء هنا وفوق inoperable أي شيء وجوه operable It's okay then the anterior اللي يصير قدام التراكيا قدام الأيورتا unfortunately they are not accessible by EBUS هسه الفيديو هسه شلون أسوي sampling this is the last slide وشلون أختار lymph node أختارها لازم تكون good size اختارها لازم تكون with good vascularity هاي اهم شيء صراحه نشوف الفاسكولاريتي مالته لا كلش بلدي لان تسوي لنا بليدنج ولا كلش دراي لان راح تنتهي بدراي سامبل this is what i do what i do scan فتحت الكلر هاي الليمف نود جواها this is the pulmonary artery هذا البلمونري artery جواها وراح يجيني منها oh, and this is the azygos This is station 4. This is 4R lymph node. هاي الليمف نود اللي راح اشتغل عليه هاي. اكو بيها accepted vascularity. تشوفون اكو vascularity بيها accepted. And I pass the needle. And I got a core biopsy. And it's revealed to be positive in this case. And he is unfortunately N2 disease. And he is beyond surgery. Thank you very much. And as I promise, I stick to the time.
شكرا دكتور علي. بس ترى عبرت التايم ما دكتور علي. أقول لك عبرت التايم. The second speaker, دكتور مصطفى مازن. مصطفى مازن is internist and pulmonologist in Baghdad Teaching Hospital. He will talk about the pleuroscopy in a pleural disease.
Assalamu alaikum. Shukri al-asatidh al-a'za. Our topic today about the role of medical thoracoscopy, pleuroscopy in evaluation of patient with undiagnosed pleural effusion. Medical thoracoscopy is an invasive technique that should be used to obtain a diagnosis only when other simple methods are non-diagnostic. Mainly, it's a primary use or primarily diagnostic yield in chronic exudative pleural effusion and diagnosed pleural effusion. هو حقيقة very similar to the chest tube insertion by means of a troca. ثم موضح الصورة. In general, medical thoracoscopy or pleuroscopy is easier to learn than flexible bronchoscopy if sufficient experience in thoracocentesis and chest tube placement has already been gained. Video assisted thoracoscopy versus medical thoracoscopy. Previously, قبل medical thoracoscopy, most of the patient, يكونون عادة friable patient, end stage patient, need for video assisted thoracoscopy عادة يكون risky such type of those patients الميديكال ثوراكوسكوبي حل كم مشكلة. فرق عن الفيديو أسيت ثوراكوسكوبي، بالنسبة للفيديو أسيت ثوراكوسكوبي هو more invasive, more expensive, requiring selective double lumen intubation under general anesthesia, multiple points of entry, operating theater, non-suitable for a friable patient. الترم على مود يتفرق عن السيرجيكال ثوراكوسكوبي. الميديكال ثوراكوسكوبي اللي احنا نسميه البلوروسكوبي فرقوا عن الباس الفيديو اسيت ثوراكوسكوبي بالترم اللي هو الميديكال ثوراكوسكوبي او البلوروسكوبي. البروسيجر بيرسونال نحتاجها هو الاندوسكوبي سوت performed by a pulmonologist and endoscopy assistant, one person to assess the endoscopist. Under local anesthesia and with conscious sedation, most of the patient we can do fluoroscopic biopsy under local anesthesia with some conscious sedation. ممكن بالoperating room العادية، ممكن بالclean endoscopic suit اللي هي نفس السوت مال البرونكوسكوبي والGIT scope. Simple description للديفايس، وحقيقة هو الديفايس يتكون من two parts: الهاندل والشافت. الهاندل هو similar to the standard flexible برونكوسكوبي، يعني بدايته تقريبا تقسيمات ما تنفس الفلكسبل برونكوسكوبي. الشافت تقريبا الميجرمنت مال 7 ملم من اوتر دايمتر 27 سنتيم ان ذا لينث. الشافت تو سكشن بي، السكشن اللي هو عاده يكون ريجيد اللي هو بدايته اللي هو تقريبا هاي المنطقه، والسكشن الاخير اللي هو فلكسبل اللي ينطينا يعني الحركه مريحه بالفول انسبكشن اوف ذا بلورال كافيتي. الانجوليشن مال الفلكسبل تيب عادة يعني two way angulation capability of 160 degree and 130 down, 160 up and 130 down. طبعا it has 2.8 millimeter working channel اللي هي ممكن نحتاجها عن طريق الاكسسوارز البايوبسيز وغير intervention خلال البروسيجر. In summary, the phases of medical thoracoscopy in the order of preparation of the patient in the case of invasive procedure, preparation of the patient, formation of consent, pre-medication. Most important one, the radiological review is a mandatory in each patient. أحياناً أغلب المرضى ممكن يعني بيوم البلوروسكوبي أو من ريد القرع البلوروسكوبي النظرة الأولية تختلف عن نظرة يوم البلوروسكوبي. البلورال فيوجن هو في الديزيز مختلف، ممكن يكون البلورال فيوجن كمية عالية في 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 وقت معين وفي وقت ثاني ممكن يصير ديسابيرنس. فالراديولوجيكال ريفيو از ا ماست اولموست اولويز حد يوم البروسيجر. بوزنج اوف ذا بيشنت، صراحة نشوف صورة شلون طريقة الوضع البيشنت، اي في لاين نيزل اوكسجين، اي سي جي، بلاد بريشر مونيتورنج، اوكسيميتر. الانتري اوف ذا بروسيجر، انتري اوف ذا سايت اوف ذا تروكر، هذا مهم ديبندن على الراديوجرافيكال تشينجز سبيشالي التراساوند. careful aspiration, أول شيء induction of pneumothorax, anesthesia, introduction of the trocar, inspection of the thoracic cavity, بعدين oral introduction, documentation of photography or video أثناء procedure, section of adhesion إذا كان في extensive adhesion ممكن أن نسوي بالsimple forceps biopsy اللي موجود بالmedical thoracoscopy إذا كان مو dense adhesion band. طبعاً نأخذ biopsies, control bleeding إذا أكو bleeding, additional procedures اللي يمكن أن نسويها خلال البروسيجر منها التالك بلوروديسيز. البوزنج اوف ذا بيشنت، عادة الافكتد سايت اللي ندخل بيه على البلوروسكوبي هو يكون فيسنج اب. والبوينت اوف ذا انتري اولموست اولويز اكثر مكان هو سيف اللي هو ذا سيف تريانجل، عادة الانتركوستال سبيس الخامس والسادس والسابع. طبعا رد نقول نفس الحكايه، every effort must be made to identify the precise level of the lesion on the radiograph or CT image that the appropriate intercostal space can be used for the point of the entry. Anesthesia required were commonly under local anesthesia with a moderate sedation اللي هو term conscious sedation. اغلب الاندوسكوبيك procedures تصير بالterm اللي هو conscious sedation اللي هو the patient remain awake or arousable during the procedure while given a mild anxiolytic and pain medication. With conscious sedation, anesthetist may be not needed. وهذه ممكن هم إلها فت cost effectiveness. Nowadays, أغلب الاندوسكوبيك procedure دي يستخدمون هو الانترافينوس بروبوفول اللي هو with or without pre-medication to provide sedation similarly to midazolam but with faster onset of action and more rapid recovery. فراح نسيطر على ال respiratory depression أقل المدة ماتها من الميدازولام. Indication, primarily indication, هو undiagnosed exudative pleural effusion. Rarely for transudative pleural effusion. يعني دائماً الإفورت لازم يعني نسعى بيها قبل نسوي pleuroscopic biopsy أو pleuroscopic procedure للtransudative pleural effusion. يعني almost always إذا أكو شك بالsystemic effusion أو transudative effusion نخلي البلوروسكوبي آخر choice. فprimarily هو للexudative chronic undiagnosed pleural effusion. Undiagnosed أقصد هو exudative بس undiagnosed بالنسبة للcytological point of view. ممكن يفيدنا بالstaging of diffuse malignant mesothelioma، ممكن باللان كانسر. احنا حقيقة أكثر الindication اللي نستخدمه هو undiagnosed chronic exudative pleural effusion. Additive benefit ممكن خلالها يعني talco pleurodesis يصير للsuspicious malignant effusion أثناء البروسيجر. Contraindication مهمة جدا. Absolute or relative contraindication هاي تفيدنا على مود نجنب دوامة تحويل المريض من مكان إلى مكان، نخصمها من البداية هذا indication ولا مو indication. Absolute contraindication هو lack of pleural space. هنا راح يجي دور الفيديو assessed thoracoscopy. Advanced empyema, pleural thickening of unknown etiology, suspected mesothelioma where the visceral and parietal surface are effused. هذه ممكن عليها بالليترشر أكثر من كلام، ممكن تبقى مو absolute contraindication إذا كان مو completely fusing. إذا أكو فد element of space موجود ممكن أكو element to do pleuroscopic biopsy via medical thoracoscopy، بس لازم نختار point of entry جيدة under ultrasound guide. Relative contraindication اللي هي أكثر شيء تتعلق بالhemodynamically stability، فأكثر شيء مثلاً يعني unstable cardiovascular or hemodynamical state، severe uncorrectable hypoxia despite oxygen therapy، bleeding diathesis، pulmonary artery hypertension، refractory cough، drug allergy لأي سبب إن كان. فالgeneral relative contraindication تدخل في أي procedure. Complication اللي واردة ممكن نقسميها هم قبل البروسيجر وأثناء البروسيجر ومن بعد البروسيجر. ممكن pre-procedure اللي هو embolism, subcutaneous emphysema and pain في مرحلة الاندكشن of pneumothorax، أول ما ندخل في بداية الاندكشن of pneumothorax ندخل التروكر. Hypersensitivity reaction للأين local anesthetic drug. During the procedure, pain, hypoxia, hypoventilation, cardiac arrhythmia, hypotension, hemorrhage, injury to the lung or other organ. هاي مهمة آخر واحدة. Post-thoracoscopic complication, re-expansion pulmonary edema, post-operative fever, common هذه عادة تكون أول يوم. Wound infection, hypotension, empyema, subcutaneous emphysema, persistent pneumothorax due to leak, اللي هو prolonged air leak. Continuation of pleural fluid production which manifests as يعني failed pleurodesis. Early and late complication or talc. Talc be complication بها حكيهم كلام طويل من ضمن ال RDS. Searing of the chest wall by the tumor cells especially بالميزوثيليوما cases or death.
دكتور مصطفى 1 minute.
نعم 1 minute. بعد بس الكيس إن شاء الله خلص. The case study for example. A 51 years old man with a history of Langerhans histiocytosis. Manifested in pulmonary and skin and CNS manifestation. He had a pulmonary complication of Langerhans histiocytosis in form of diffuse cystic lesion with two bouts of spontaneous left-sided pneumothorax treated with chest tube. Skin manifestation كان عند scalp lesion وال CNS manifestation كان عند diabetes insipidus currently كان على الديسموبرازين. هو active smoker with obstructive spirometric study non-alcoholic. Duration of the illness كانت 11 years. الدياجنوزز تول كانت او الدياجنوزز وهي حقيقه كانت بالالماني هو مشخصي عن طريق سكن بايوبسيز. الانيشال الديزيز برزنتيشن هو كان سكن. الميديكيشن اللي كان يعني تقريبا بهاي الدعسنه اللي عليها هو اورال ميثوتريكسيت فور سكن ليجن فور سكن لانجرهانز هيستيوسايتوس. تقريبا دوز ريليتيفلي هاي كانت ياخذ 220 ملغ بير ويك. البيشنت حقيقة referred to the pulmonology outpatient department for evaluation of a chronic left-sided exudative pleural effusion. The primary analysis can exudative hemorrhagic blood-stained effusion with a remarkable cytological exam. A non-enhanced contrast CT chest can diffuse cystic lesion bilaterally
وأكو left-sided pleural effusion. Just 1 minute.
نعم صراحة خلص.
Just 1 minute.
خلص. واكو بريكارديال افيوجن الميدياستانال ويندو اسف ما كانت موجوده. الترانسوراسيك ايكو كان مايل بريكارديال افيوجن. Diagnostic evaluation, طبعا pleural biopsy was discussed with the patient and the ongoing possibilities behind the doing a pleural biopsy. Differential diagnosis count معناتنا neoplastic effusion and a neoplastic effusion being smoking, ممكن a neoplastic effusion one of the possibility. Other possibilities هي تكون chronic infectious process أو chronic inflammatory process like due to the disease itself. A little bit literature ماكو due to the disease itself, بس ممكن تكون due to another chronic inflammatory process. Medical thoracoscopy was discussed with the patient as a next diagnostic tool. Pleural fluid اللي سحب كان blood stain كمية تقريبا كانت 1600 أخذت biopsies. وهذا الفيديو to see the involvement of the parietal pleura. أقدر أمشي أسرع شوية. البارايتال بلورا ديفيوزلي إن هيموراجيك ماكو فد نودولاريتي واضحة, بس أبارت فروم أول ذا كلوت أكو فد ديفرنت ماتوريشن ستيجز أوف بلودي إفيوجن. أكو بي قديم صاير كلوت, أكو بي نيو. نودولاريتي واضحة, تيومر واضح بالبارايتال بلورا حقيقة ما موجودة. بايوبسي تيكن يعني راندوملي احنا من نكون نشوف ماكو فد ديفيوز انفولفمنت او ماكو فد ليجن واضح ناخذ امبريكلي من يعني رفلي من اي مكان. هنا نريد نشوف بس السيست اللي ديفيوز سيست انفولفمنت اللي هو باللنج, راح تكون هاي الكولابس لنج اللي باقي, هاي البارايتال بلورا اللي اعتقد هذا الدايفرام تشان, لا عفوا الابيكال تشان, هذه اللنج اللي هي كولابس لنج دنسلي انفولفمنت وذ سيست. Multiple pleural biopsy were taken. Fluid, adnan fluid aspiration with cell block, can non-specific. Acid fast basal stain can negative. Diagnosis can pleural biopsy, non-specific inflammation. مناطف في الدجرانيولوما, مناطف في النيوبلاستيك سيل. انطينا انطباع انه ينطي ايزينوفيل كاونت, هو حقيقه ما كان حاسب الايزينوفيل كاونت بالفلويد, بس طلع الجرام نيجاتيف والوايت فيس العفو الدفرنشال 27500 كان الار بي سي, وايت فيس منها 185. ثانكس فور افورت فور دكتور امير ظاهر ودكتور حسين الغسان, هم اللي يعني اشتغلوا. سو وي ار فيسينج لونج ستاندينج هيمولوجيك بلورال افيوجن ان ذا سيتنج اوف سيتش هيستوري وذ ا ريماركابل هيستوباثولوجيكال اكزامينيشن. حقيقة بقينا احنا بهذه الديفرنشيال, يمكن تكون ديزيز ريليتد, ممكن تكون روماتولوجيكال كونديشن, ممكن تكون دراك اندوست. وانا فكرة الميديكال ثوراكوسكوبي ان تيكينج بايوبسي, هنا مثلا جنبنا الامبيريكال انتي تيوبركلوسيس اللي هو الموجود, جنبنا هذا باعتبار هو على اميون سبريشن هاي ريسك اوف تيوبركلوسيس موجود, بس هو بالنتيجه بالبايوبسي ما طلع هيك شيء, هذا هم جنب الامبيريكال تريتمنت. فبقينا ما بين هذه الثري ديفرنشيال. استجماته of rheumatological disorder كان ماكو لا clinically ولا serological test. Disease related a little bit due to Langerhans histiocytosis, هي rare presentation due to histiocyte infiltrate. حقيقة كان MDT discussion with the dermatology unit, لأن هو كان البروبلم هو كل ما يقطع الميثوتريكسيت ويقلله.
Dear, you have used 6 minutes extra.
خلص خلص هذا آخر استعد إن شاء الله, آسف. كان القرار نقطع الميثوتريكسيت, نبدي اورال بريدنيزولون وذ اورال نينالدمايد اس ان الترناتيف تو ذا ميثوتريكسيت فور ا بروسيود ميثوتريكسيت اندوس بلورال بريكارديال افيوجن. ذا كومبينيشن اوف بريكارديال اند بلورال ديزيز هاز بين ريبورتد ريلي ديورينج كرونيك يوز اوف ميثوتريكسيت. حقيقه اوكي ساعات قاعد تتكرر هوايه بالميثوتريكسيت, هو مورر بالنسبه لنا نشوفه هو. Drug induced infusion has been well described, especially in neutrophilantoin, بس الميثوتريكسيت has not fully implicated. نحتاج thorough investigation should be undertaken in the setting of methotrexate use, should be included in the differential of diagnosis of pleural pericardial effusion إذا المريض كان على methotrexate should be kept in mind. Almost the effort should be يعني taken to discontinue methotrexate إذا أكو شك. Severity of the underlying disease لازم تقيم وراء قطع methotrexate. ورا ما نشوف الكمية الدوز اللي يأخذها وال duration of the illness take on consideration على مود blaming the methotrexate as a cause. تقريبا كان during methotrexate therapy كان هذه البروفيوجل initial وإني كانت تقريبا after 3 months after methotrexate discontinuation ultrasonographic finding كان ماكو بروفيوجن just remnant of pleural thickening my longest standing pleural effusion. Patient قطع الميثوتريكسيت من ذاك الوقت حاليا على بريدنيزولون and لينالدوميد and he is doing well. Recommendation early referral of the patient with unexplained pleural effusion. This is the last
excuse
slide.
Me so no we have so 17 minutes
early referral of the patient with unexplained pleural effusion to a pulmonologist to assess the need for a thoracoscopic pleural biopsy. Early referral will make a pleural procedure easy. Referral can be made after first and conclusive oxidative pleural effusion. ما نحتاج نعيد مرة ثانية. Preferably, ها كلش مهم ال point. A good amount of fluid should be left for doing easy pleuroscopic procedure. 50 to 100 cc ممكن تنسحب initially ونخلي الباقي for doing the procedure safely and easily. Delay in doing pleuroscopic biopsy will make the procedure more difficult, possibly due to the presence of adhesion, thickening, or other complication of long-standing pleural effusion. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Dr. Mustafa Mazen decided to don't give up until 18 minutes, so it is okay. So you have got it. The third speaker, Dr. Mustafa Na'ma, about cryotherapy, please.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. We have a new procedure in pulmonary medicine, which is a cryo technique. Thank you to all who share this procedure to be successful. Dr. Sabah Nouri, Dr. Ahmed Khamas, and the rest of the faculty. In addition to what the scientist did, Dr. Hajar, I think, is present here. Thank you very much. The principle of cryo procedure is easing effect of a cryo probe. We benefit from freezing for diagnosis and therapy in pulmonology. هذا طبعا يعتمد على rule of using low temperature by CO2 according to George Thompson rule. ما يحتاج يعني ناخذ تفاصيل مالتها بس temperature اللي ممكن توصل هي ناقص 35 ناقص 50. Bronchoscopic cryo probe used for biopsy, devitalization and for adhesions. أعتقد هذا ما يشتغل. Tissue response, we have a cryo-sensitive and cryo-resistant tissues. Tissues اللي تستفيد من الكريو هي skin, mucous membrane, granulation tissue, and tumors. While cryo-resistant tissue اللي ما يفيدها ما يشتغل وياها الكريو fat, cartilage, fibrous tissues, and connective tissues. Which is the normal airways. فمعناها لما نشتغل احنا bronchoscopically with the cryo procedure, cartilage will airways ما راح تتأثر هواي. The tumor will something inside the bronchus, foreign body, mucus, okay. بس الكارتليج قد ما تنطي cryo ما راح يتأثر. فهذا الشيء جيد جدا. Cryo adhesions used for collecting tissues, extracting foreign body, clots, mucus plugs, especially large and hard mucus plugs. And recanalization of tumors. Devitalization. The aim of freezing is devitalization of tissues. لما نستخدم الكريو, this will lead to ice crystals inside the for the tumors, for the cells. Ice crystals lead to death of the cells. Death of the cell leading to necrosis of that tissue. And this will lead to ablation of the tumor. هذا الإفكت مال كرايو كريستاليزيشن راح يتأخر عدة أيام حتى بعد البروسيجر. فمعناها the death of the tumor cells will continue several days after the procedure, not just immediately, even weeks. Cryo ablation is a palliative care, adjunctive therapy. أكيد إحنا مو هو التريتمنت الوحيد. شو كنت نستخدمه؟ لما ال patient يجينا with severe dyspnea, severe distress, يجينا with strider على سبيل المثال. This is time in order to have the last procedure, مثلا chemotherapy or surgery, open surgery. This is also used in inoperable cases. يعني يجي case, cranial tumor large, advancing metastasis, no role for surgery. فتستخدم هذه as a palliative treatment. Also used with chemo and radiotherapy, it will help. The depth of tissue is 3 millimeters, depth 3 millimeters. Therefore, if you have a tumor, you will crystallize, and this depth will not extend to the wall of the bronchi, so it is relatively safe. It will not damage the bronchi. Complications are bleeding in the rate of 2% maximum, not different from the forceps biopsy, because forceps biopsy also have this percent. We have patients, 51 patients studied in this procedure, divided into two groups. Group one is diagnostic, group two is therapeutic. We have the theater in order to do the procedure, like this picture, one of our patients. We need a major operation, theater, anesthetist, other طبعاً cardiothoracic surgeon لازم يكون موجود. So in the group one, we have a 44 patient, 26 male, 18 female, mean age 47. All have undiagnosed diffuse lung disease. احنا عندنا diffuse lung disease بس ما نعرف شنو الدياجنوزز مالتها. It is non-typical in the CT scan for usual interstitial pneumonia. Or the patient have progressive disease not goes with known, well-known cause of interstitial lung disease. And after the procedure, the diagnosis settled in 89%, so it is a good diagnostic yield. We have, okay. So the final diagnosis is interstitial lung diseases and classified. Most of them are non-specific interstitial pneumonia in 57.9%, and other type, other group, desquamative lymphocytic, and other diagnoses including HB, caseating granuloma, cellular bronchiolitis, and vasculitis and aneuploidism. It's complication bleeding in 18 and pneumothorax in 2% of these patients. This one of the our cases, diffuse interstitial infiltrate, not typical for usual, not typical for non-specific or other. A procedure taken with the cryo. This is the good sample in the tube, about 1 centimeter. So we have two samples, so 2 centimeters تقريباً عندنا كل واحدة one, which is good for pathologists for diagnosis. And the diagnosis was non-specific final diagnosis. This is another case, which is also the not typical CT for any diseases. This is the sample taken, which is also a good sample. And the diagnosis was usual interstitial pneumonia, so it was probable. And with biopsy, it was settled, the diagnosis. This is the third case, and this is the sample taken. The bleeding is important complications, and actually not so easy sometimes. Therefore, we need a surgeon with us. We need a rigid bronchoscope, we need a theater. And look to the bleeding length of the clot compared to one of the ampoules here. So it is a long, about maybe 3-4 cm, sometimes bleeding severe. Group two was the therapeutic group. We have 7 patients, 6 male, 1 female, the mean age is 55, all have bronchial tumors. And recanalization was successful in 100%. The bronchial obstruction was total complete in 6 and not complete in 1, not total, يعني. And the type of the bronchial obstruction was, sorry, complete in 6, okay. This is one example. 45 سنة عندنا male and recurrent pneumonia, okay. This is the CT scan revealing a tumor in the right main bronchus, and this is the pneumonia adjacent to the obstruction. What you can do for this? Actually, صحيح راح نقول احنا bronchoscope, بس bronchoscope revealing this large vascular mass in the right main bronchus. So what we can do for this? لأنه near the carina operation, I think difficult, and the surgeon, discussion with the surgeon, it is primarily to be taken by the cryo, and then the decision of chemo or other surgery. And this is the bronchus after removal of this large tumor. طبعا البروسيجر تطول مرات ساعة ساعتين إلى حد ثلاث ساعات. يعني it is not so easy. And this is the tissue and the tubes after devitalization of the tumor. يعني كل هذا التشو طلع من هذا المكان. And this is a good على كل حال the cough and pneumonia and the diagnosis was carcinoid in this patient. Carcinoid in many literatures sometimes the cryoablation is totally therapeutic. It is not just palliative treatment. So in this bronchoscopy interventional pulmonology, they have 63 patients with complete remission in 1/3 of these cases after cryoablation. هذا مختص بس بالكرايو بالكارسينويد كرايو ان كارسينويد. Case 2, we have this lady with dyspnea and strider treated as severe asthma. So we need to be cautious in cases of severe asthma not responding to usual therapy. We need to do a CT scan. We need sometimes a bronchoscopy. This is the trachea. This is the obstruction of the left main bronchus. And this is a large tumor which is taken with cryoablation. The case 3 also diagnosed as asthma. Okay, ما يخالف الفيديو. This is the tumor in the mid part of the trachea. Tumor with lunar-like lumen here. Also, the a procedure taken, and this is a large, nearly completely obstructing the trachea. The patient presented with strider lately, and this is the trachea after removal of much of the tumor. إلا أن بعدين نشوف البيوبسي والنتيجة اللي راح whether operations or not. And the this is the tissues removed, and the diagnosis was adenocystic carcinoma of the trachea. We have a child. I will not forget this child because the father said, you are the doctor number 13. You are the specialist number 13 for management of my child. And my child had asthma and not responding to treatment. Just انه انت شوف الحقيقة يعني الموضوع بانه the patient شوي عنده strider نفكر بانه there is some obstructive lesion in the upper airway. هذا البيشنت كان عنده ديستريس ودخل للإنعاش وسوى خلوه الاندوتراكيال تيوب and this is the CT scan with this redundant tissue here and this is the upper part. الحقيقة we are in the supraglutic area. يعني هذا اللارنكس هنا وهذا supraglutic يعني تيومر طالع من جوا اللارنكس إلى فوق اللارنكس. It was very difficult. الحقيقة كان موجود الـ ENT surgeon بجانبي وتساعدنا أنا وياه حتى نشيل هذا التيومر والحمد لله بعدين مشت وطلع هذا صح it is not so large like the picture بس البكتشر هي مكبرة. هذا هو التيومر اللي طلع and it was the pyogenic granuloma. Pyogenic granuloma, the patient responding completely and fully after the treatment with the cryo and with antibiotic. This is another case.
You have 1 minute. Maybe you have got 2 minutes over to us, so you can continue 1 minute more.
Okay, inshallah. Well, I have videos, يعني لطيفة بكيفكم بعد. This is also a child with severe asthma and several treatment cochionoid with steroid. This is the obstruction of the trachea seen by CT. And also a tumor was removed from this 12 years old child. يعني احنا صح هو child بس tumor ممكن يكون موجود benign tumor ممكن يكون موجود. And the diagnosis with biopsy was inflammatory myofibroblastic tumor. It is not common, rare tumor. Sometimes recur in other organs. Therefore we discussed with the surgeon about the what is called sleeve tracheostomy. هم الأساتذة الجراحين أعرف من عندي. So, in conclusion, cryo is a technique which is very important in respiratory medicine, used in diagnosis of interstitial lung diseases and other maybe tumor. وعندنا من الكيسات واحدة كانت alveolar cell carcinoma. إذا تحبون أكو مجال دقيقتين أشوفكم. لو أوكي. أوكي. ممكن نشوف الفيديوهات من فضلكم. Okay, this is the case of right main bronchus tumor and proved to be carcinoid. وبدت البروسيجر يعني شوي شوي piecemeal taking of tissue الحقيقة after crystallization and devitalization. وإذا نشوف نهاية المقطع أو أنه tumor is removed for most of the right main bronchus. الكيس الثاني also we have this is the trachea and large tumor inside the trachea and also removed near totally, ما نقول totally, near totally, at least you can open the trachea. هنا عندنا هذا الكيس مال interesting الحقيقة. إذا نشوف هذه CT scan مالتنا with the total collapse of the left lung with أكيد لما نشوف هيك راح نتوقع اكو تيومر ان ذا ليفت مين برونكس. عندنا صورة قبل وصورة بعد البروسيجر. هذا ريجيد برونكوسكوب وندخل بداخل الفايبر اوبتيك. This is a tumor occupying most of the left main bronchus أو تقريبا totally left main bronchus. أزرق. وبدأت البروسيجر أكيد بالتدريج وبعدين هسه راح نشوف الصورة اللي ما بعد أو المقطع اللي ما بعد البروسيجر بعد عدة أسابيع طبعا. يعني لما تدخل هسه بالبرونكوسكوبي يعني راح تصور انه هذا مال غير مريض بس هو بالحقيقة بنفس المريض باقي جست the remnant of the tumor فقط باقي عندنا بالليفت مين برونكوس. اوكي هاي بس بقايا التيومر في على حافة البرونكوس. ما اريد اطول عليكم ونشكركم شكرا جزيلا ونتمنى لكم بالمستقبل كلكم تشتغلون هاي البروسيجر.
استاذ مصطفى very nice presentation. The fourth speaker is Dr. Raibaz. APAS experience in Par Hospital.
Good afternoon. For today, I'm very honored and esteemed to be here amongst my friends, my colleagues, and my teachers as well. I will be a little bit fast because we have a stick time. Today, I'm talking about the EBAS, and we know that we have to know that what we can do just beyond the walls, because you know, EBAS, it's going fast, and I'm not talking about the indication. And there is one thing regarding the central mass, we have to know that what's the fate of central mass. And don't be surprised if you see sometime even a consultant physician sending these patients for CT-guided biopsy. And there is one point I want to declare here. Should endobronchial ultrasound give every transbronchial needle aspiration guide? And there is another thing that we have asked to ourselves, can we drive our cars on the road with highlights off? And definitely no. We should not drive our cars, even if we are very much familiar with the roads. And another thing is we have to know that this is a sample taken by the EBUS, and this is a sample without the EBUS. If you are using ultrasound, our ways is much clearer. And it's time to turn on the lights and be confident that our chances of safe arrival in the next destination is more than 90%. This is, I'm not talking about this because it's a repetition. And if you consider yourself as a gladiator, you have to know where is your arena. And this is a mediastinum. It's not working. Yeah. This is a mediastinum. And this is a central compartment, and the lung is not part of the mediastinum. We have superior and inferior mediastinum. And regarding the lymph nodes, this is a very busy slide, but this is much easier. There is, we have 2, 4, 10, and we have 7, and sometimes even 11. And regarding the one, we does not need an EBUS. The 2, it's usually this is a superior vena cava. We have a transection of the imminent vein. The above till the manubrium cerni, this is a 2, 2R, and as Dr. Ali said, this is a very important slide for any EBUS biased IP doctor. And the two left, you know, these slides that are all repeated here. Yeah, regarding the three, we have 3A and 3P. Regarding the three anterior, it's just in front of the superior vena cava. We cannot get there by the EBUS, but 3P is just retrotracheal. Sometimes we can get this through the either esophagus or sometimes by the ibis as well. And regarding the pre-P, no pointer, very difficult to be explained. Yeah, this is a 3P, just in front of the vertebra, we have a 3P, just posterior to the manubrium sternum, we have a 3A. Okay, and regarding the 4, which is very important, because if it's 4 appear to be positive, this patient is diagnosed an N2, that's why. We have 4R and 4L, as we see here, we have a 4 here, 4R extending from the upper part of superior vena cava till to the azygous vein. Azygous vein is very important on the right side, because proximal to the azygous vein, we have a 4R, and distal to the azygous vein, we have 4L. And regarding here, 4R is very clear. And I hope we have a pointer, but still not. And we have a 4L here. In this is 4R on the here. This is a 4R. This is superior vena cava. Okay, and we have 4L. We have to be fast here. Okay. This is, we have 5 and 6. We are not getting there through by the EBUS because it's very far. This is, we have 4R, 4L, but here, we have, this is 6. Yeah, 7 is very important, as we know here. We have upper border, the carina, and lower border. Right side, the middle lobe, and left side, the lower lobes. We can get there. Later on, we can talk about it, more details. Regarding the 7, we can go on both sides, right and left side. Regarding the 8, and we have 8 and 9. 8 is below the carina. 9 is in the inside the pulmonary ligament. Sometimes we can get there through the esophagus, not through the endobronchial, because you know this is a carina, and we will be finished here. And 10R, as we hear, this is a superior vena cava. This is a transection prominent vein. Okay, this is a 4R, we said. This is a zygous, anything proximal, 4R, anything distal. This is 10R. Here, it's very obvious here. And regarding the 11R, we have as well here, from the here, we have 11 till 14, it's interlobular. The rapid revision. Yeah, these are important slides. As we see here, this is 2R, this is 4R because this is superior vena cava. Okay, this is 4L, this is a Mickey Mouse sign, this is a aorta and pulmonary artery here, this is a 4, again, this is a 7, and this is not a leaf node, this is a mass, this is, seems to be 10. Yeah, mediastinal leaf nodes is very important. I think Dr. Ali talked about the mediastinal leaf nodes. And there is one thing in staging we have to know that, if you have a mass from this side, for example, here, anything, for example, from this side, it become N1. Yeah. N1, 10. This is N1. Anything from the side of the mass, ipsilateral. And anything from the 10L to 10 to 14, it become an N. N2 is very important. We have a 2, 4, and 7, and even below, because we know that the differentiation between N's is very important, because N1 is usually, for the surgery, is very important. N2, it's usually chemo and radiotherapy. Same. And landmarks is very important. Yeah, it's a very busy slide. We have to know one thing. Whether we can access by the EBUS or we cannot. If we cannot, we can use the EUS, transesophageal. And it's a very easy procedure, by the way. And leaf nodes that can be accessed, we know that's 2, 3P sometime. 4, usually 7, 10, these are the mains. And by the EUS, we can get usually other things, including 8 is very important, and 3P. This guy. And we have to be, this is the same, we have to be usually systematic if you don't have a target lesion. If you have a target lesion, for example, just one leaf node, we can directly puncture the leaf node. If we have, if you want to staging, for example, we have to go from 4L, then 7, then 10L from the left side, then go to the other side from 10, then azygous, then up. And these are the stations regarding the EBUS, how we can get there. If you count the five rings, from the right side, this is R2, from the left side, this is L2. 3P, we can go through the trachea or through the esophagus. 3A, we cannot get there. 4L is very easy. It's usually between the pulmonary artery and the aorta. Okay, this is this window, this is a 4L. It's usually, it should be large because if we puncture sometime, even the aorta, it could be dangerous. But this is usually 4L means N2. That's why we have to take biopsy most of the time. And this is called Mickey Mouse sign. And here, that are very much obvious here. Regarding the 4L, we have to go to the left side, usually before the carina, this is the 4L. And 4R, it's usually on the right side, before we are going to the right upper. 4R, it's also very very important. We have to find superior vena cava. Just anything above the superior vena cava, this is 4R. Then we have to find azygous vein. Anything proximal to the azygous vein, this is 4R. Distal to the azygous, this is azygous vein here. Anything proximal, this is 4R. Anything distal, this is 10R. This is superior vena cava, and this is 4R. Azygous vein, as we said, is very important. Yeah. Azygous vein here, this is an azygous vein. If I could just get back here. Yeah, this is azygous vein, anything proximal 4R, anything distal, this is 10R. These are azygous veins. Okay, you have to be, okay, 10R, distal, usually we are entering the right upper, this is azygous vein, this is distal to the azygous vein, and just we are entering right upper lobe, this is a 10R. 10L, it's usually on the left side. This is usually on the left side. Yeah, this is, and this is station 7 on both sides, on the right and the left. On carina, you can go and find the station 7. 11R, usually, it's between the right upper. This is an 11R superior. We have superior and inferior. I think, I have a better picture mentioning everything. Oh, sorry. Okay, and let me get back.
Dr. Rebaz, you can speak about your experience in 3 minutes.
Okay, that's it, I'm done, okay. And we have, and we have 11L, just give me time, this is an 11 superior, and we have 11 inferior, okay? 11, and on the right superior, right side, and these are from 11 till 14, it's usually between the lobes, okay? And here we have 11 inferior, and 11 left side, we have just one. There is one thing I want to talk about. There's sometimes there's a problem once we are trying to intubate the patient, because this is completely different from that, what you are seeing in usual bronchoscopy, because we have an oblique view. That's why we have such kind of view, and we have to go in a neutral position. We should not try to flex it, because even sometimes we are, it could be traumatic. And why it's a game changer? Because it's minimally invasive. It's we can stage everywhere and we can puncture everywhere. And according to guideline, it's if we combine both of them, this is very important. We can combine this is called complementary EBUS. We can combine EBUS and EUS through the at the beginning through the bronchi, then through the trachea. Then we can be very specific, and definitely it's more accurate if you combine both of them. It's reaching 91%, even it's definitely it's better than this one. Always talk with your patient, this is very important, and explain every pros and cross to your patient, because I know complication is very rare, but sometimes you could get a catastrophic complication. In conclusion, it's considered to be very safe, complication is almost negligible, and mortality is very rare. Thank you. I stick with the time, I think.
Not more than 2 minutes. Any question about this session? Anyone you have a question about this for speaker? Yes? Yalam. Dr. Muthanna.
السلام عليكم دكتور مثنى العسل كونسلتنت كارديوثوراسيك سيرجن. سؤالي للاستاذ مصطفى نعمه regarding use of cryotherapy in
in tumor. In palliative cases, it is understood, fully understood, you are doing palliation. But removal of a tumor, and after a few weeks, we see a remnant. You can remove intra-bronchial tumor, but the inside bronchus, inside, and the tumor outside. What's the point of doing cryosurgery and the tumor is still there in the tissue?
عاشت ايدك صحيح هو الكلام هو just a palliative and temporal treatment يعني مرحلة انتقالية يعني مثل هذا البيشنت اللي شفنا قبل شوية كان عنده obstructive pneumonitis يعني recurrent pneumonia at least انت تخلصها من هاي recurrent pneumonia حتى الاوبريشن
ما just temporary bridging to the surgery
just هو كل الحلول اللي شفناها هسه هي temporal ما عدا in cases of metastasis advancing non operable يعني ما عنده غير حل
أكيد.
شكرا جزيلا عشيدك. شكرا جزيلا
الكارسينويد ريسك مال بليدنج يكون عالي فبنسوي
سؤال استاذ حيدر الكارسينويد ريسك اوف بليدنج which is very high during the procedure yes it is high but you are controlling with rigid bronchoscopy with other section procedures يعني احنا هم تعلمنا على هذه الطريقه بانه when you are dealing with a tumor vascular tumor bleeding is high شفنا قبل شويه البليدنج كان موجود بس انت ما عندك غير حل يعني تتعامل ويا البليدنج يعني تتعامل البليدنج with suction تتعامل البليدنج with intubation بس الحمد لله يعني ما صار ديش الكومبليكيشنز اللي وصلت لهي المرحله شكرا جزيلا شكرا
any question دكتور لو
شلونك دكتور مصطفى بس ارد اعرف الشغله اذا انت تستخدم الكرايو فور باليشن على مود تسوي اكسس او اوبننج للتريكي ان ادفانس كيسز وذ انفيجن الاندوبروكيال انفيجن تيومر از وي نو ذا يوز ستنت الاندوبروكيال ستنت Is this technique?
مع الأسف الستنت لحد الآن مو أصلا يعني بس شكرا جزيلا ملاحظة كلش مهمة يعني in such of advancing tumors in the trachea after the procedure use stent إذا عندكم stent نشتغل تسوي شكرا جزيلا بارك الله فيك
شكرا جزيلا okay there is no another question we go for discussion لو لانش
دكتور بس just doctor Just one note, doctor. Can I comment on one thing? Comment on one thing?
Yes, you can come.
Okay. Regarding the cryobiopsy, nowadays there is a new technique, what's called cryomediastinal biopsy. If there is a lymph node, for example, mostly for lymphoma and for sarcoidosis cases, yeah, and 1.1 newly invented procedure actually by Hari Kishan. He is from the India. He's one of the well-known IP. He used to puncture and go through the site of the puncturing and taking a biopsy through the cryo. And it usually you have a chunk of biopsy, and it's usually very beneficial in a case of if you cannot just take a proper piece. This is one. Second notes, nowadays this is the era of immunotherapy. Usually in our hospital, we make just a rule. If we take FNA after doing a ROS, we will take a biopsy, and we will take multiple pieces, and we can just cooperate with the oncologist. They will be very happy if you need, for example, any immunological marker to be sent, and later on for biological assessment. Thank you.